Welcome, everyone. Boy, we had a lot of people waiting. It's awesome. Okay, I have someone who's trying to get in. Chat. Morning, Pam. Okay, we have a problem with someone trying to join. And I'm waiting for my co-host. Christine Jones is joining us today from Bookshare. Laura Ronberg usually does the webinars with me, but today we get Christine, which is cool. I'm going to try and get you a link to our cheat sheet as well. So just give me a second here. And I even have a press record post-it note on my screen. Forget to press record. Let's see here. Okay, I'm pausing the record. Okay, welcome everyone. We're so happy that you're choosing to spend some time with us. I'm Mary Jo Berry from Delphin. Everyone calls me MJ. And I'm with Christine Jones from Bookshare Benetech. And so we're going to jump right in because we have a lot to share. I'll let Christine tell you a little bit about herself. And yeah, let's get going. Your cheat sheet link has been pasted into the chat box. So if you'd like to refer to it as we're doing the session, you can do that if you want to look at it later. So welcome, Christine. It's all you.
Thank you. I think you have to make me host again.
I can see you full screen.
No, I know, but I have to share my screen. Oh, I can share. Okay, I should be good. Yep, I'm good. Okay, awesome. So great to be with everybody, and I'm excited to tell you about how Bookshare can be a great source of content that is accessed through the Dolphin Easy Reader tool, which we love. We promote it all the time and offer you know, limited training on it, and we have our own video and, you know, how-to guides and things to be able to explain how to use Bookshare. How to use Dolphin to access Bookshare books. So we think it's a great solution and looking forward to telling you more about it. So do you want me to just jump into the Bookshare part now? Okay, perfect. All right, so let me bring up some slides. I'm just gonna go through some basic background on Bookshare for anybody who's new. Let's see, okay. So Bookshare and Dolphin Easy Reader. So just for some who may not know, Bookshare is an ebook library that makes reading easier. And our focus really is people with what we would call reading barriers. And that would include things like dyslexia, blindness, physical disabilities. I'll get into a little bit more of the qualifications in a minute, but basically people who need text in a different format. So it allows them, you know, a different format other than printed text. It allows them to listen to books read aloud. If they just want to listen and, you know, just want the book in audio, they can also follow along with audio and the highlighted text, which of course Dolphin makes possible and is such a valuable benefit for students, especially with learning disabilities, to increase their comprehension. There's actually a lot of research that's been done on the value of this kind of reading, text-to-speech is what it's called, where the word is being read out loud and highlighted on the screen as well. So students are getting that multimodal experience. And students can read in large type if they want to just enlarge it, if they need it larger because of something like low vision. And they can read in Braille. So basically they can read in the way that works better for them. The collection has 850,000 titles, so lots of books in a variety of genres, fiction, nonfiction, generally all the bestsellers are in the collection, all the books that students are using in school these days, as well as lots of other resources such as textbooks. So we have about 25,000 textbooks, including 14,000 from the NIMAC, which is a federal repository of K through 12 textbooks in a digital accessible format. And those can be accessed through Bookshare. And the NIMAC itself has actually many more than 14,000 titles. So Bookshare is a conduit by which people can access those materials. So lots of textbooks, books for both assigned and pleasure reading, and then books for what we would call upskilling, learning new skills, whether it's cooking or learning a new computer language, or we make it possible for students in every state to access the manual for the driver's education test, the driver's test that you take when you get your driver's license. That manual is for every state is now available in Bookshare. So students who have learning disabilities, for example, or low vision might be able to access the manual and study up, for the exam. Memberships are available for free to all qualified U.S. students of any age, funded by the U.S. Department of Education. Qualified adults can still join. Anyone with a qualifying reading barrier can join. If they're not a student, then they would pay the $50 a year for an unlimited number of books. And Bookshare really allows reading a customized reading experience on many devices. And of course, Dolphin is one of the main tools that offers a lot of that customization. I'm sure that MJ is going to show us all about that. So this is just some of the many ways to read Bookshare books on devices such as Chromebooks or computers. With Bookshare Web Reader, Bookshare Web Reader is a web-based reading tool that doesn't require any downloading at all. The student logs in, sees a book, and selects a button that says read now, and it opens up in a browser. And there is functionality in the browsers that allows the words to be read out loud and highlighted, just that text-to-speech reading that I mentioned earlier. And this is possible in Chrome, in Safari, and in the latest version of Edge, the new Edge. Browser supports that functionality, and that's a free way to read Bookshare books. And that experience can be enhanced with extensions available in all of those browsers from TextHelp called Read and Write and from Don Johnston called Snap and Read. So we recommend that educators take a look at those as well. CaptiVoice is another tool that offers integration with Bookshare and the ability to read in different formats, different ways. All Bookshare books can be downloaded as Microsoft Word documents and uploaded to OneDrive and read in a variety of ways. And then, of course, on tablets such as iPads and iPhones and Android tablets and Android phones, Dolphin Easy Reader is definitely our go-to app because it is free and it's available on both iPhone and Android and has a lot of wonderful features and integrates directly with Bookshare. We also recommend CaptiVoice and Voice Dream Reader, which a lot of our members love as well. There are two types of Bookshare accounts. There's an organizational account, which is what schools usually get. Their teachers get added to that account, which we call sponsors, and they add students, which we call members. And we use that terminology because we serve organizations that aren't schools, so like libraries and other community organizations. So we don't refer to everyone as a student. We refer to them as members, and teachers are sponsors or facilitators is another way to look at that. And then the student, those teachers add qualified students to the account. And then those teachers log in, the teachers assign books, then students log in, find their books and read, but they can only access books that have been shared with them by their teachers. The other option is an individual membership, and this can be sort of two ways that this can be set up. One is for the student and the parent. A student signs up separate, apart from school, then submits what's called a proof of disability, And then the student can access any book in the collection that they want, but the school, but their account is not connected to a school account, which means teachers cannot assign books to them. So the best scenario is sort of a hybrid of these two, where the school has the student first on their school account, and then the parent can upgrade to a full individual membership that's connected to the school. So the student gets full access to the collection, but the teachers can also push books out to students. So we really recommend that method. And that's explained here on this next slide. So teachers can initiate an individual membership, adding an individual membership to a student's school account through our website, or parents can initiate the process on their end when a student is logged into their school assigned account. And then they select a link that says upgrade to full individual membership from the left-hand menu. And then the parent completes the form and the student then has access to the full collection. So that's really the scenario that we highly recommend. To qualify for Bookshare, someone has to have one of these different criteria, meet one of these different criteria under revised copyright law, which basically says an eligible person is one who is blind or has a visual impairment or perceptual or reading disability that basically limits their ability to read the way someone would who didn't have that kind of impairment or disability. And then someone who is unable through physical disability to do any of the actions that we think of when we think about reading a book. Hold the book, turn the pages, focus the eyes, endure the length of time needed to read. All of these can be characteristics that could qualify someone for Bookshare. The decision is made by a competent authority who is someone who possesses experience in making such determinations. And we have cross-qualification agreements with Learning Ally and the National Library Service for the Blind and Print Disabled. So if someone is a member of one of those organizations, they can use that as a basis to qualify for Bookshare. Getting started is pretty easy. Teachers create organizational accounts, add students, assign books, either one at a time through a feature called Assign and Read, where they just assign one book at a time to a student, or they can assign collections of books, either lists that we push out, that we make available publicly, that are by author or by topic, or grade level lists and things like that, or teachers are welcome to create their own list or some hybrid of the two, and they can assign entire lists of books to students at one time. So then students would log in if they're not already signed up on an account, find the books and read. We do have a great page, a couple of great pages right now for educators and for parents. We have some learning at home resources. And if I can take a minute, I'll just go ahead actually and jump over to the website and show that. So let me do that really quick.
We only have one question, which is while you're launching that, is there a web reader for Mozilla Firefox?
So currently the way that Firefox works, you could launch the Firefox browser, a student could log in, see their book and click read now, but and the book will open up in the browser. So they could see it in large type, they could, they could use a separate screen reading tool to read the book, but Firefox itself doesn't have the capability that I talked about before. Read the book out loud and highlight the words. That's not yet available in Firefox. So there may be other extensions. I'm not that familiar with Firefox to know if there's extensions or other tools that work with that browser, but the browser itself doesn't have that capability.
Okay, a few more questions. I downloaded Bookshare on my iPhone. However, I cannot find it when I search for the app on my iPad. What am I doing wrong?
So you're saying you downloaded, I'm not sure downloading Bookshare, what you're referring to. If you're referring to you downloaded a Bookshare book, or you're referring to downloaded Dolphin or a different app that reads Bookshare?
Yeah, Beth, can you clarify? And while you're doing that, Bookshare doesn't have an app, Beth. The readers have an app. But not actual Bookshare. It doesn't have an app. It's on a You have to use a URL and a web page.
Yeah, so what we've chosen to do is work with a lot of third-party companies like Dolphin that make great tools to read books on a wide variety of devices and platforms. So the only thing that we really offer, we actually have an app called Read2Go. Some of you may be familiar with. It's been around for quite a long time. That is an app that we have offered for a long time to read Bookshare books. It actually has a cost associated with it too, so it's not a free app. However, we're no longer supporting Read2Go. We're no longer updating that app. So at some point, it's going to stop working with iOS as Apple continues to update their iOS system. And that's really because we decided that our resources were better spent keeping our library, making our library as good as possible, making the books available in a variety of formats, and working with these companies like Dolphin, who are much better at reading tools and have, frankly, much more bandwidth than we do to keep maintaining those. So that was a decision that we made. So Bookshare itself doesn't actually have an app. But I can show you first of all, I wanted to show you the Learning at Home page. It's on the Bookshare page over here in Learn at Home tips, get tips. There's an educator subpage and a parent subpage. There's also some great information here for anyone who doesn't qualify for Bookshare. We have information on where they can get content books, basically. So Bookshare itself makes available more than 10,000 books that are what's called freely available. They're not protected by copyright law for one reason or another. And so someone on our team went through and made some lists of these. So free books for all, free upskilling books for all, and free children's books for all. And there are some great instructions here for how to access and read those freely available books. And then we make available here links to a lot of other sources that are offering either free or dramatically reduced content right now. So we definitely want to connect you with as many sources as possible for quoting materials.
Can you post that link in the chat box for them?
Sure, absolutely. Yep. And then I'm happy to go in and show, Bookshare Web Reader if we have time, but you can.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Let me just go to the chat. Copy this page in.
Okay. I know that Nolan raised his hand, so I'm trying to get to him.
I'm trying to get to the chat. Okay, here's the chat. Okay, let me put this link in to this Learning at Home page that has a lot of great sub pages to it. So check that out. Let me go ahead and share again, and I'll show a book being read. So this is the Bookshare website, and I'm logged in as a student currently, one of my demonstration students. So when that student logs in and they go to My Bookshare, they see their books that have been assigned to them here. This one has 17 individual books assigned, and then this student has also been added to a lot of reading lists. This is my demonstration student, so this student gets a lot of lists. So one of my favorite lists is one called Books to Film, which is books that have become movies. That's sometimes a great hook for kids, a great way to get them to read is to get them interested in a book that has become a movie. So like Little Women, for example, or one of my favorites is Wonder, The Secret Garden, Call of the Wild, Artemis Fowl. So this one has some really fun books. The Sun is Also a Star, To All the Boys I've Loved Before, A Dog's Way Home, etc. So the student can log in, and if they've been assigned to this list or any book, next to it, they're going to see a button that says Read Now, and they just click on that. I'm in the Chrome browser right now, and it opens up, and they can actually change the settings so that the text is larger. This is using something called the Beeline Reader, which is a color gradiated text, which some find to be helpful, especially some students with learning disabilities find that to be helpful. And it allows I gotta make my box smaller so I can make the font a little larger. So it basically color gradates the text so that the end of one line is the same color as the beginning of the next line. So you can see like this line ends in red and the next line begins in red. And for some that helps with tracking. So that is something that students can certainly look into if they want. But once the book is open, then they can hit this play button.
How
here.
I Came to Life. I like when mom tells this story because it makes me laugh so much.
Okay, and then as I mentioned, the whole experience can be enhanced with extensions that are offered by some other companies like TextHelp makes Read and Write, the Read and Write for Google Chrome or Read and Write for Edge or whatever the browser is that's being used. And it's the little purple puzzle piece that can be added on top of the web reader and used as an enhancement. So
I like when mom tells this story because it makes me laugh so much. It's not.
Okay, so I like that the contrast is better than in Bookshare web reader and it's a little bit better voice. So it's one of the tools I like to recommend. And then Snap and Read from Don Johnston offers some similar features. It works a little differently, but it's another tool that can lay on top of Bookshare web reader. So those are great, great and very simple ways for a student to read. So MJ, I'll turn it back over to you unless there's other questions you wanted me to answer.
I've been trying to answer them as we go.
Great, thank you.
Are you going over how to assign books? Can you show how to assign a book?
Sure. I'm gonna jump over to a different browser to where I can be log in as a teacher. Because I was currently logged in as a student. So let's see here. Okay, so going back to the, so I'm in a different browser. I'm going to log in as a teacher to an organizational account. So once I'm on an organizational account, I have a couple of ways I can assign or search for books. If I know a specific title, I can title of a book, I can enter it here. If we want to go with PS, one of those books that was on that list, you can just hit the search box and here it is. And then they can select the assign button over here. And when you click that, then it brings up your student list. So you pick which student you want to assign it to. I can add a couple here. Or you can add all the students, whatever, and then you click the assign button. So that, or you can go into the browse page if you're not sure of a title and you're interested in just seeing all the different things Bookshare has to offer. One of my favorite sections, actually two things. One, under for teachers, we actually have leveled reader collections and Lexile collections. So actually I'm going to click on leveled readers because it has. So we have books by Lexile level. So you have a whole list of books in these Lexile levels. So you can share the entire list or you can share, you can assign, you know, individual books from these lists to a student. So again, opening the list, you can assign, you can subscribe to the whole list by using this button up here at the top, or you can assign just one book at a time by using the assign button.
We have one question. Is there a way for the sponsor/teacher to download the same book that is assigned to students to read along with and create assignments? That's from Janice Barber.
Yes. So the way that the teacher would do that, so let's go back to, let me go back to my account where I'm logged in. I think I am logged in as a teacher now. So you could download it for the student. So for example, if we were to go back into that list I was just in and take the book that I was looking at here, you have a download option here. So you could download it you have to pick the student for whom you're downloading it. Let's see. Oh, now it's given me the chance to add a new member to the account, which is not really what I wanted to do. Okay. Well, in any case, that it should come up with your whole list of members here. I'm not really sure why it's just giving me this one member, but you can pick it in all these different, any of these different formats. So you can download it, for example, as a Word document or as an EPUB. EPUB is the format that, well, it's many reading tools use EPUB. I believe even Dolphin can read an EPUB file. Definitely the Apple Books app on both Macs and iPads reads EPUB, so that might be an option. If you're gonna download it in DAISY text or BRF, you have to have a device that reads those formats. And this is audio, which is, may or may not be what you're looking for. But yeah, teachers can download it for a specific student. It's really intended for the student, but we understand that teachers like to be able to have access to the same text to be able to, as you say, prepare materials or just preview, you know, what the student's reading experience is going to be. So that would be the way to do that. Another option is to log in as the student and access the book that way. And the student has those same options to either open it in Bookshare Web Reader or to download it in one of those formats.
We have one more question from Nolan, and moved. Is there any way I can copy books from Safari to Read2Go? Reason that I'm asking is because I'm having problems doing it using my iPhone XR. I'm running iOS 13.4.1.
Yeah, so as I mentioned earlier, Read2Go is an app that we offered for a long time for reading Bookshare books, and we're no longer supporting it. We're no longer updating that app, as you know, as you often have to do with apps, as MJ knows very well. So we actually would recommend that you use a different app, and that it's good that you're here today. You can learn about using Dolphin instead of Read2Go to be able to access the books, and MJ's going to show exactly how that happens, how that works. Because I believe what might be happening is that iOS has surpassed, the Read2Go cannot work perhaps with the current iOS, the current operating system, the current iOS. So that might be what's going on there.
And Yvernette Anderson, she wanted us to answer about how we used a different reader to read the text. So you can choose from the link that Christine gave you to the Bookshare resources page. There are lots of different options for you to use there, all different kinds of apps for you to choose from. It's really about what fits best for you, but most of the time you're going to download the app separately rather than read it on the screen in the URL. That's the best way to go with the most functionality. Wouldn't you agree, Christine?
Well, yeah, I mean, in some ways, the easiest way for a student to read is to log in and find the book and click that Read Now button. It's going to get them in the book the most quickly. But to your point, it doesn't offer a lot of functionality. There's no bookmarking. There's no ability to add notes or any, and the voices are limited. The customization options are limited. But in terms of just purely getting a student into a book and reading, that's the fastest way. But
yeah, I agree.
But the second fastest and most effective way, and definitely one that offers a lot more features, is to use an app such as Dolphin Easy Reader to read the books. Okay. I did see a question in the Q&A. And about the connection between Dolphin and Bookshare. And I think that's the whole point of the webinar. So that will be, I think, fully explained. But just again, think of Bookshare. So if you think about your Kindle device as the device or the way that you read the books, but you have to go to the Amazon store to get books for your Kindle. So Bookshare is like the Amazon store, except that the books are free. So Bookshare is the place you'd actually get your content. And then how you read your content depends on, you know, so for example, now the Kindle app is available for a lot of other devices besides Kindle. So you could read a Kindle book on an iPad that's not a Kindle, but through the Kindle app. So similarly, Bookshare books can be read on a lot of devices too, with an app or with certain software So Bookshare is the library, and a tool like Dolphin is the app that's used to actually read the books.
Yeah, I think a lot of your questions are going to be answered once we get into Easy Reader. I know that Nancy Larson, we're going to answer your question inside the app. Noah, I saw your question. We are recording this, so you will get a follow-up email if you missed the beginning. No worries. So I'm going to jump into Easy Reader, and I'm going to switch my camera now.
And while you're doing that, just can I answer one quick question that was in the Q&A from Nancy? Can parents access the reading level books, or is that just for teachers? As a parent, I need help finding appropriate level books for my son. So the Bookshare collection is searchable by anyone. You can't download a Bookshare book unless you're a Bookshare member. But you can certainly search and look at the lists and get ideas from that. So absolutely. Just go to bookshare.org, then go to browse, and then for teachers is the button that you want to get to for all those leveled readers.
Okay. Let's see. Am I the host?
Yeah, I can see your screen. Yep.
Okay. Am I on the big screen?
Yep.
Great. Okay, so we're going to jump right into Dolphin's Easy Reader to make a few clarifying points. Just to reiterate, Bookshare is the library. Dolphin's Easy Reader is the reading tool. So you separately create a Bookshare account, and then you separately go to the App Store, whether you're on an Android or an iOS device. You can download the Easy Reader app, and that's all you have to do is go to your App Store and search for Easy Reader app. Once you do that, if it's the first time that you open your Easy Reader app, you're going to have to create an account, which is just a name and an email. First name, last name, email. Once that's done, you have a Dolphin account. I get a lot of questions about this. Your Bookshare account is not the same as your Dolphin account. So you can use the same username and sign in if that's easier for you. But when you create your Dolphin account, that is your way of signing into the app. Okay. So I'm going to get to how you sign into Bookshare. But when you open your app for the first time, you always land in a place called My Books. Now, the first time you open your app, you're not going to have any books in your books. But if you refer to your cheat sheet, or if you have that on open in a tab, your what we call the side menu is in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. And whenever you touch that little book icon, your menu pops out from the side. So the default view when you open Easy Reader is the My Books. That's basically your library, everything you've downloaded. So you can read your books offline whenever you want. We're going to go over here to the side menu. And when that pops out, you'll see that I can continue reading what I'm reading. That's my first option. And then there are a list of other things that I can do. I can visit My Books. So like I said, those are all your downloaded books. I can share here on the Easy Reader Share, but that's a little more advanced. We're not going to get into that today. We're going to go directly to Manage Libraries. So as you can see, Bookshare is the first option here. We connect to the world's biggest book repositories, accessible book repositories. Here in the United States, it's Bookshare, and in Canada, it's CELA, and I believe Bookshare and CELA are one now, right? Is that true? Well, she can clarify. That's all right. CELA and Bookshare, are you one entity now?
No, I wouldn't exactly say that, but...
But your things are available across?
Yes.
Okay. So again, that doesn't even matter unless you're from Canada, but I know there are a few Canadians on here, so I saw that. So Sila is your library. Again, we have Project Gutenberg, NLB, and then your Dolphin Library. We're not going to talk about that today either. Newspapers, if you're a member of NFB's Newsline, that's mainly an entity for the visually impaired or people who are blind. You know, you can also access that library. So the very first time you sign into Bookshare, you're going to have to put your Bookshare login, you know, the credentials. So I've never logged into NLB. This would be what would happen, except for it'd say Bookshare at the top, and you'd have to type in your username and your password for Bookshare. But in this case, I've already signed into Bookshare before, and I've read lots of books, and I've searched for books. So that's, we're already signed in. Once you sign in to your library one time, your Bookshare library, you're forever connected in Easy Reader, unless you, you know, download it, get rid of it, re-download it. You won't have to enter that twice. Okay, so here we are in my Bookshare library, and you see that I have some options when I get in there. My reading list, and I believe Christine went over how you can create and assign reading lists. So that's where those books would end up. My assigned books, I've been assigned some different books. Here are some of my textbooks that I've been assigned in a reading list that the teacher created for me. My favorites, I might have some favorites here that out of all the books that I was assigned or that I chose, if I have an independent account that's also connected to my school account. And then I know that we had a parent ask before about ways to sort. So we do have the latest. So these are newer releases. We have what's trending under popular. We have browse by category, which this is the teacher's favorite area. But now that all you parents are teachers, this might be your favorite area too. So you can look at specific topics, lots of different topics for you to choose from. This is how Bookshare sorts by topic. And then browse by grade. Here's another great search feature within Bookshare. Now, of course, you'll, as the teacher, probably be looking at this in your browser. But here, if you have an independent account, you know, even a student could look up different, you know, grade level texts or areas of interest in the browse by category. Lots of great things. So another thing I can do is just search for a book. So up here in the top is a search bar, and I would just type in, let's see, what's a new book? Does anybody have a new book that just came out? Or I saw one and I just lost it in my head. Go ahead and send me a chat. Or how about I can look for, oh, I know. I'm going to look for, what am I watching on Netflix? Altered Carbon. Okay, there it is. Altered Carbon. If you're not watching it on Netflix, it's a nice sci-fi. So once I find books, and whether they've been assigned to you by the teacher or not, you've just organically found them through searches. If you go to info, which is a little button to the right of the book cover, if you go all the way to the right of your screen, you'll see this little eye. If I select that, I'll get the synopsis of the book or the summary of the book, and then my download button is there. So if I want to download this book, all I do is hit download, it prepares, and it's going to place this book. Boom. It's done. Now, guess where that book is? I can either open it from here or I can go back to my books. And there it is right at the top. So that's how quickly you can get a Bookshare book, right? And if you notice here, info, these are all books that I've downloaded. If I go back to my Bookshare library, let's see, these are my reading lists. Here's my test list. Well, naughty me. I have not downloaded one of the assigned reading materials that my teacher has assigned to me. So I need to do that. You'll always know what's happening by that download book. And then once you're in my library or my books, if I just open my assigned menu, you can delete books here. There's a little trash can at the top. So whenever I hit that info button, I get a pop-up menu that gives me the opportunity to open and play that book or trash it. The other way to open or play a book is to just tap on the title, and here I am inside of a book. I'm going to go to another book that I've actually gotten from my Bookshare library. I'm going to go to The Boy in the Striped Pajamas because we had a lot of questions earlier about images. And so this book is the deluxe illustrated edition of The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. So the first thing we're going to do here is just play a book.
One afternoon, when Bruno came home from school, he was surprised to find Maria, the family's maid, who always kept her head bowed and never looked up from the carpet, standing in his bedroom, pulling all his belongings out of the wardrobe and packing them in four large wooden crates, even the things he'd hidden at the back that belonged to him and were nobody else's business.
Wow, that was all one sentence. So it feels like a run-on, but you'll notice that we have a background color, we have a sentence color, and then we have word-by-word highlighting. So if I scroll down, you'll see that the yellow is indicating that's all one sentence. If I moved on, these all seem to be very long sentences. If I move down here, I can start playing from anywhere.
Take your hands off my things. Maria shook her.
Now, we had a specific question about images. Does it read image descriptions? Easy Reader does. Whatever, if there's an alt tag on the image, Easy Reader handles that. That's a lot of work, and some books haven't been tagged, but I know that all of the libraries are working on that. You know, they're getting better and better at tagging different images. Before, not a lot of readers could even accept images, and now that we can, it's like playing catch up. But the question that someone had asked is, you know, are the pictures there? So yes, they are there in Easy Reader. Okay, so some of the other obvious things that you might want to do when reading a book is adjusting it to suit your needs or your student's needs or your child's needs. It's dynamic in terms of you can use your fingers to grow or shrink the font, which I'm doing right now. There's a book mark on this page, so it's letting me know that I'm blowing it up outside of the bookmark where I wanted to navigate. But the other way to deal with preferences is to actually go in the upper right-hand corner. So everything related to text is under the icon A. When I select the A in the upper right-hand corner, I get a dialog box that pops up. And there are things like text size that are here, so I can use my slider to adjust my text size. I can choose my fonts here if I don't like this font. I happen to be in Century Gothic, but I can go to the book's default font, or we have other fonts that we know are better for people with certain disabilities. So you'll see we have the Open Dyslexic font here, which I can apply that. Now if I just hit my back button, I go to my preferences again. If I want to adjust my margins, so I don't want them all the way to the page or to the end of the visible screen, I can do that here. I can make it small like a column. I can increase my line spacing to like triple space. I can even do letter spacing. So for your kids who have trouble ocularly that need those words, the letting actually spaced out, you can change that. Then at the bottom, we have color schemes. or color themes. Color themes. So you can individually change each of these. The default here is text is black, light blue is the background, sentence highlight is yellow, and then word highlight is orange. But if you don't love that, you just select color, select the arrow and go to the color theme. And so we can do high contrast, different shades of that. Again, if you want to turn the text yellow, you can do that. We have some cream colored background, and then back to my light blue that I was working with. I'm only using that because it seems to show up good on the elbow camera. Okay, once I have all that set up, I just tap the screen to go back. But I can also, while I'm up here in the upper right hand corner, there's a speaker icon, and I can adjust my audio settings here. So I can choose voices. Here's one really cool thing to note about Easy Reader. If you have bilingual students in the US, the voices that are installed with Easy Reader, it's the North American edition. So you'll get French, Spanish, and English automatically installed to your device. Those are the voices installed. If you have a Mac or if you're using iOS, you usually get better word choices that are voice choices than you do on Android. You can see I have a ton of them here. But back to what I was saying about the North American edition, because you have French and Spanish and English already installed into Easy Reader, if your student switches text between, say, Spanish and English, it reads flawlessly. So that's great for your bilingual students. You don't have to do anything to change the language there. Okay? If you want to add other voices, you have students who maybe speak a different language and you're using some of those texts, you can actually add voices by purchasing them. And you can do that on both the Android and the iOS. So let's say you needed a language that wasn't there. You can actually buy them, and they're very inexpensive, $6.99. So that'll meet your needs if you're working with a bilingual student. Okay, so in voice settings, here's where I can do all those things like set my rate, my pitch, my volume, pauses, at punctuation. All of those can be done here if I want to increase that. And I don't think I want to speed it up, but whatever, I'll try it. And I can play it here to see if I like it.
Press the play button to test your voice settings.
Yeah, so I'm going to go back to 50%. And we'll try it here.
Press the play button to test your voice settings.
She sounds a little whiny.
Press the play button to test your voice settings.
She smokes Marlboro.
Press the play button to test your voice settings. Press the play button to
there
test
we go.
Your voice settings.
Back to normal. So you can do all of that here and using your back arrow. Now we have everything the way that we like it. So while I'm also in here, we've explored the buttons at the top, all except for our bookmark. So remember, all the way to the upper left is our side menu. And then we have a search. We can search for words or key phrases within the book. We can set a bookmark. So if I tap on a word, it highlights that word in the sentence. And then if I double tap on the bookmark, it brings a dialog box up that allows me to either make a note or set a recording. This is where she tells the truth. Oop. Okay, I have to hold it down, sorry. This is where she tells the truth. There we go.
This is where she tells the truth.
So then I hit save, and there's my bookmark right there. And if I'm reading, it'll indicate that there's a bookmark coming. Did you hear that ding? If I go up here.
Big boys, fathers and grandfathers, perhaps a few uncles too, and some of those people who live on their own on everybody's road but don't seem to have any relatives at all. They were everyone. Who are they, ask?
So you get an audio prompt whenever you have a bookmark. Now we're going to find out how to easily navigate a book. We had some questions about that. If you go to the lower left-hand corner, I'm just going to scoot this up to make sure you can see it. There's what looks like an index down at the bottom. And that brings a dialogue box up too. So you can search this book inside Easy Reader by headings. Because someone had asked earlier, like, how do our students get around all the copyright stuff? Well, you know, if the book is well tagged, it'll have contents and introduction and all that stuff. So you can jump right to chapter one and navigate that way. I'm going to open the navigation box again. So in addition to headings, you can go by page. So if the teacher is saying, you know, refer to page 10 and you have a student with a disability in the same class who is included, they can also get to page 11. If, you know, again, depending on the quality of the books, but most of Bookshare's books are tagged really well, so you'll be able to navigate that way. And then bookmarks, we can also navigate by our bookmarks. So when a student's done and they've made notes or audio notes, they can go back and cruise through it looking at that. Then at the bottom, we have our play button, which you've seen me tap.
One. Bruno makes a
and pause, and it just toggles back and forth. And then we have 15 seconds forward and backward that we, if we want to quickly go back, we can do that.
It allows us to have heated conversations with our closest friends and dearest loved ones.
Discovery.
And all, no one gets hurt. One gets taken away from their homes and no one gets killed.
Okay. I pressed them both at the same time, and apparently you can do that too. I didn't know that. Okay, so I'm going to pause right here. I know we rolled through quite a bit, and I'll accept any questions while I have the app open. I don't know where we are on
Jay,
questions.
There are, let me, I can shout out a couple to you that sure. I saw that. So one was, are the features available to someone who is blind? How would they use it?
Well, we have quite a few visually impaired individuals using it, and honestly, there are no guides, but once you become familiar with the prompts, there are six at the top and then two at the bottom. So once you become accustomed to where those are, you know, that helps. I would say someone with a visual impairment, you know, legally blind, it's going to be more beneficial there than someone who has total sight loss, because loading your books is going to be tricky. But you can use VoiceOver on the Mac to supplement where there is no feedback, you know, within Easy Reader, and using those together. I actually have a video tutorial on how to do that, that if you send me your name, I can personally follow up with you and get you that information, how to use those two things together.
Yeah, that was part of the question too, using VoiceOver and using a Bluetooth Braille display.
Yep.
With the iPhone. So if you can, send some information.
And Braille, and on that note, Braille Note Plus includes Easy Reader. It's the standard reader inside of HumanWare's Braille Note Plus. So if you're looking for a refreshable Braille display, go with that.
Okay. And then another question was, if a student doesn't have an iPad but has a desktop, is there something similar to Easy Reader for the desktop that can be used to expand voice options during text-to-voice, text-to-speech reading?
There is. There is. It's a full program on the, and it's available on the Windows platform. It's not free. Like the apps are free. It's $59, but there is a full version for a desktop machine that is available. I'm going to quickly, these seem like questions that aren't demonstration questions, so I'm going to switch back to my.
Oh, can I? I wanted to clarify something really quick,
sure.
MJ, which is, you were, I think, logging into Bookshare probably to a full individual membership.
I was.
Bookshare, yeah. Right. So I wanted to clarify that because some folks whose students just have a school account will only be able to access books that have been shared with them. And you guys do have that reading list link, which is nice. So if a student has been assigned a particular reading list, when they log into their Bookshare account within Dolphin, they'll be able to see my reading list and they'll be able to access any lists that have been shared with them. But as far as books that have been shared individually through that assign and read function, there isn't the assigned books. Like when they log in on the website, they see assigned books and reading lists, and they're not going to see assigned books per se because you guys aren't supporting that particular feature yet. But what they would then do is they need to search for a book that's been assigned to them within Bookshare. They need to search for it. And if it's been assigned to them, they'll be able to download it. If they're only on that school account and they search for books, but they're not books that have been shared with them by their teacher, either on a reading list or assigned individually, the students won't be able to open them in Dolphin. So I wanted to make sure that was clear. That's one of the reasons we highly recommend parents go ahead and help their student upgrade to a full individual membership.
Yeah. Okay. So in the end, I'm just going to take the last 3 minutes to show you a little something here. I'll give you a sneak peek at Easy Converter. A lot of you ask, how can I make documents for my students to use in Easy Reader? And here's how we can do that. So I'm gonna open this. Oh, it's read only. Okay, here's one that's not. Okay. So using another tool that we have called Easy Converter Express, and I'm just gonna share my screen. Is that sharing okay?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
What I've done here while I was trying to talk and open a document at the same time, I'm not very good at multitasking like that. So what I've done is I've just opened a Word document, but prior to this, I've downloaded our new app called Easy Converter Express, and Easy Converter Express is available in the Microsoft Store. So it's only on the Windows platform. And what it does is it gives you a way to convert formats, inaccessible Word formats, into all of the most widely embraced accessible formats. So for instance, this Word document, if I wanted to make this an EPUB document, all I have to do is go to the button that has been installed into my Word toolbar and click Convert. And can you see the drop down? I know it doesn't show up sometimes. Is it there, Christine?
Sorry.
That's okay. Anyway, hopefully you can see the drop down menu. I have a choice of EPUB, MP3, Braille, large, or large print. So I can make this file anything I want to make it. I'm going to go ahead and say EPUB. And it's going to ask me, where do I want to put this? So I'm just going to say my desktop, and I'm going to say start, and it's going to create that for me. Now I have an EPUB file. Well, I will in just a second. It's preparing, and I don't need to show the location, but I'm also, while I'm at it, I'm going to go ahead and create an audio file too. I'm going to say start. So while those are being made, I'm going to open my email and I am going to send this to myself. And the audio file is still being made, but I'm still going to add my EPUB file, which is on my desktop. And I'm going to go to desktop
And webinar instructions, okay. This is my audio file. And then I'm going to also add my EPUB file. Okay. And I'm just going to send it. And the reason I'm doing that is because it's the easiest way for me to get it to my, my machine. So now I'm going to stop sharing. And I'm going to go back to my other camera, which is still on, right? And I'm going to get out of here. And I'm going to go to my email, which I've just sent to myself. And here it is. Now, hopefully you can see the screen okay. My two files are down here at the bottom, and I'm just gonna select my EPUB book, and it doesn't open, obviously, because it can't. But you know that little button here at the top? Let me go up here. You know your send button? It's different in Android, but similar function. If you're an Android user, you know what I'm doing. So I'm sending to an app that will open it. And if it's not listed, which it's not, I just hit more and Easy Reader will show up in my list of available apps to read. It'll launch it, load it, and open it. So that's how quickly I can make a file for my Easy Reader. I'm pretty sure I can put an MP3 in here. Let me go back to my email and say done. I'm gonna do the audio.
Here's instructions. How to upload videos onto YouTube. Steps. 1. Go to Zoom and then choose recordings in the side menu. 2.
So there's the audio file that I made. Now if I want to set it up to default to a different app to open my audio files, I can do that. And there are other ways I can copy things into my Easy Reader app, but that one I think is pretty fast, and most students can open an attachment, and most parents know how to do that. So I'll take any questions on that. But we're at our 1 hour, so if you have questions, I'm happy to look at that. Can we hear readability of the Easy Reader? I think that was a long time ago. Thank you. My students usually need it slow. Oh, book navigation is found at the very bottom of Easy Reader. Let me go back to Easy Reader. It is down here at the bottom. If you look, it's this little, it looks like the table of contents. Okay. Oops. All right. So you go to the Microsoft Store to download it. Easy Converter Express, yes. That's the facility that allows you to convert Word to anything. You know why that's so great? Just especially in a school district or any organization, you know, if you're the special ed teacher and you're getting documents and things that you need to convert, this gives you a great tool. Well, actually everybody in the accessible educational materials chain, it gives everybody the power to create accessible formats on the fly, and all of the formats all at one time. So and what it's just very cool. I love it, and it's low cost. So yeah, Microsoft Store, and remember, go for Easy Reader to your app store, either the Google Play Store or the Apple Store. That's all we have time for today. We'll stay on a little while longer. But if you want to hang up, you can go ahead. Yes, Easy Converter Express costs $69. Easy Reader costs nothing. Easy Reader is a free app. Really helpful, MJ or Christine. Yes, you can email us. We can type, I'll type my my email in here. And anybody who wants a certificate of attendance, I'm happy to create those for you if you'll just email me. Here's my email address. Here's another, I am gonna send you a follow-up email that will have a link to the cheat sheet, the slides, and the recording of this should you wanna share this with any colleagues. Thank you for your time, everyone. All right, do you wanna stay on with me, Christine, if they have any other questions? Will high school US history textbooks, for example, have an audio version as well? I think that depends on what's available in the Bookshare library. We are just the reader of those formats. But if you're asking if we can handle audiobooks inside Easy Reader, you bet. And I have a couple from the Bookshare library in my library. And if I just go to my side menu, and I go to my books. I got these, all of these from Bookshare. Here's an audiobook.
I would picture myself owning a marvel of an automobile. It was always a Mercedes, a Citroen, or a Volvo. I imagined myself behind the wheel.
So, I mean, that's perfect for whoever needs it. You know, the bummer is it doesn't have highlighting text, but if someone is blind, obviously they don't need that, and all their books can be audiobooks. Can the Easy Converter Express be downloaded onto a computer? That's where Easy Converter Express resides. Easy Converter Express is not an app, it's an actual program for your computer. It's an add-in, and it plugs into Microsoft Word. So, yeah. Okay, I see people signing off now, so I'm gonna say this meeting is over. Once again, thank you so much for spending your time with us. We really appreciate it, and stay well, everyone. We're almost out of this. Mm-hmm. Goodbye.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.